Hi there, and welcome back to SpreadsheetPoint.com. In this video, I will explain how to create an amortization schedule in Excel. The easiest way to do this would be to simply use a template. There are literally hundreds of templates available online to create your own amortization schedule. So if you have an internet connection, that would be simply the best way to do this. Let me show you how. You're going to File. And then you will go to New Sheet. And here it says Online Templates. I'm going to type in Amortization. And I will click Search. And you will see that there are, well, not hundreds, but there are, looks like six available here currently right now. I like this one here. I'm going to click that. I'm going to hit Create. So, and here's your amortization schedule right here. These are the variables that you enter in about your loan and payments and interest rates. And then here's the amortization schedule here. You'll see the loan period in years is one. Let's say I'm going to put 2 years. So there will be one number of payments for year 12. You see how this changed already? It brings it down. It's all dynamic, and all these formulas are set up for you. So that is probably the best bet if you're making an amortization schedule in Excel. I'm going to close this version off here. If you don't have an internet connection and you just want to throw one together quickly without any formatting or anything like that, here are the steps to do so. So I'm going to go through this quickly with you now. So in column A, you're going to list all of these items. So let's do that now. I will do that on the schedule tab. So loan amount. These are the titles, okay? And then in B1, you're going to enter the actual values, okay? So let's take out these. These are just essentially headers or titles for the data, okay? So loan amount, let's just do 100K. Interest rate is 3.75. We'll put that as a percent. Like so, make the decimals so we can see the decimal. Loan term, let's just do 2 year. Payments per year, 12. It's a monthly payments, let's say. Okay, so these two steps here, step one and step two. Now, use the payment formula to calculate the monthly payment. It wants me to do that in C5. Here's the formula right here. Excel has a great payment function that calculates payments for interest loans to use on an amortization schedule. It's quite powerful. I will copy this formula here, and I'm going to put that in C5. Copy. I'm going to go to C5. Put that formula. There's my payments. Okay. This tells you what that formula actually does. Now it wants me to create the amortization table headers in row 7. Okay. So I'm going to copy all these over. I'm going to go to A7 to start, and I will paste values, special, and I'm going to transpose this just so it puts it across just like that, okay? So A7, B7, payment date, all of these are the headers where all of the data is going to go. Okay, now it wants me to fill in the amortization table. So in A8, start with 1. So I will go A8, start with 1, just like that. In A9, use A8 plus 1 to increment the payment number and then drag down the formulas to fill the column. So I will go equals A8 plus 1. I'm going to drag it down. There should be 23 or 24 payments. Well, we'll put it to 24 and see what happens. That's 2 years. It's probably not going to take the full 24 to pay off this loan, but let's see. Let's see what happens when we start entering the data. Payment date. In B8, enter the start date of the first payment. B8, payment date. Let's do 1/15 of this year, okay? Say it's make it nice and easy, start at the beginning of the year. In B9, use E-date B8 plus B8-1 to increment by 1 month. So this basically is a formula that increments each month by 1, okay? So I'm going to take this formula, copy. And it wants me to put it in B9, paste. Make sure you format this the same, like that, just like that. And I will drag that all the way down as well. I want to see the year, so I'm going to format these cells, date, year, just like that. So it goes into the next year, as you can see. Okay? And then drag down the formulas, which I've done. Beginning balance, C8. So in C8, use equals B1 to set the beginning balance. Of course, that makes sense. That's a loan amount. So C8, beginning balance, equals B1, loan amount, 100,000. Okay? In C9, use G8, the ending balance of the previous row. So that makes sense. So C9 is equal to G8. So C9 equals G8 is the ending balance, of course, of this payment. That makes sense. It's a zero, of course, because nothing's in here yet, right? If I put 50K, you'll see it lowers it by 50, okay? But we're not quite there yet. Payment, D8 onwards. So use C5, right? Because C5 is the payment calculated earlier with this formula up here, with the PMT function, rather. So I'm going to use this formula here, equals $ C5, and put it in D8. D8. Just like that. And it wants me to drag this all the way down, because that's the payment per month. Interest. In E8, use C8 times B2 divided by B4. This multiplies the beginning balance by the monthly interest rate. So let's take this formula. And it wants me to put it in E8. E8. Like so. So it just calculates the interest like that, right? It's taking the beginning balance times the interest by the payments per year. This is how much interest you're paying. Okay? So these technically should add up. Let's just see if they do. Principal, in F8, use D8 minus E8. So, well, that's quite easy. That makes sense. D8 minus E8 in F8. So F8 equals D8, right? Payment minus E8, the interest. Obviously, that makes sense. So these two numbers add up to your payment now, 43,31,37. Ending balance is C8 minus F8. To subtract the principal from the beginning balance. So C8 minus F8 is in G8. So if I go to G8, C8 minus F8, right? Because you're subtracting the principal by the beginning balance. Interest is obviously something you're paying extra. Okay? Copy down the formulas. Highlight row 8 for columns A to G. A to G here, row 8. We're going to just copy these ones because these ones we've already done, basically. Okay. Actually, this should already have been done, like so. Now we're going to copy these ones down. Okay, just like that. Perfect. So you'll see it does go all the way to the bottom here. The ending balance in the last row should be close to zero. And it's zero. Just like that, the ending balance. So this did take the full 2 years to pay off. You see the end beginning balance is 43.17. The last payment is 43.31. And that the principal that you're paying is the exact amount that you owe for beginning balance. And here's your amortization schedule. Okay? This is how you create it here. The steps are all here. You can have this file. But again, the best way to do it, if you have an internet connection, is just go to the templates. They're much cleaner, much nicer to look at. Some of them have charts. But if you need steps, if you're not connected to the internet, these are quite easy to follow. It tells you the cell by cell where to put the data in the formulas. I hope you found this helpful. Please visit spreadsheetpoint.com for further help and hints. And don't forget to like and subscribe.